Well friends, this is our English class and today we are going to learn a very interesting lesson in your from your book, that is Footprints with Our Feet. This is the science era and we are living in science era, and that is why we are very advanced. Okay, we have developed many technologies and that is why our life becomes so relaxed, comfortable. But sometimes there are certain consequences, means ill consequences, or we can say bad consequences of the science, because of the development of the science, development in science. Because the motto behind development of particular thing should be right, or should be for the welfare of the society. But sometimes people make the invention to destroy something, right? So because of science we have got many things by which our life becomes so very smooth, and we are very comfortable in this our life. But on the other hand, if we think about the science, we can understand that there are many drugs are there which is made available for the people, by which many inverse things are also happen in the world. So basically what I want to say here, that science is boon also and bane also. It has certain advantages also and disadvantages also. So that's what we are going to learn in this lesson. Before that, I'm going to introduce the today's that lesson, that is Footprints Without Feet. Actually the name of the book also same, and from that book we are going to learn the same lesson, Footprints Without Feet. So what is the, who is the author of this lesson? Herbert George Wells, who has born in 1866 and died in 1946. So if we think about the Herbert George Wells, so he is an English, he was an English writer. He has written dozens of novels, means dozens of novels, you know that we are learning only one novel, but he has written dozens of novels. So by this we can understand his greatness. So he is one of the eminent member of the English literature. Okay. Second, he has written short stories. So we can see that he has written many literature in all genre. Okay, that is why he is a superbly admired by the people of literature. Okay, those who are lover of literature, they admired him in a great extent. So he was an English writer. He has written dozens of novels. Then he was also a short story writer. Work of social commentary also he did. Again, satire, satire means what? Writing something about the particular thing in a opposite way. Satire, okay? Satirical also literature he has written, biography, autobiography he has written also. Then two books on the recreational war games also he has written. And last one, but not the least, by which he is known for the world, is he is the father of science fiction. It's a new genre in English literature that we are learning, that he is called father of science fiction. So by which we can understand his greatness, his contribution in English literature. So today we are going to learn the lesson about the science fiction only. Okay, already I have told you there are certain many advantages also and disadvantages of the science. So today we are going to learn one lesson in that one scientist, what he did, he invented something by which a person can be invisible. Okay, and then after getting invisible, then what he did, that we are going to learn today in this lesson. Then how he take the advantage of that, how he robe the people by his own creation, that we are going to learn through this lesson. So we will start the lesson, which was written by, already we have learned, Herbert George Wells. Okay, and what we have learned about him, that he is an all-rounder writer. He has written his literature in all genre. Okay, so we will see the lesson. The name of the book is Footprint Without Feet, and the lesson name also the same. So we'll see that. First of all, we have seen one movie. If you remember, if you recollect, Or suppose you will ask your mother and father that, was there any movie, Mr. India? So in that, it was, Anil Kapoor was there in that movie, who was leading, playing leading role in that movie, that was Mr. India, and he was invisible person, and then anybody would be seen by the red glass, then only he was visible. And then how he has used that invisibility for the betterment of the people, that we have seen. So in that movie, we have seen that one scientist had introduced that particular invention, and which was used for the good betterment of the people, for the good things, not for the bad. But in this lesson, we will see that that scientist, the name of scientist is Griffin. He's a scientist and he's a lawless man. Lawless man means he doesn't care about any law. He was not following any law. He was totally against of law. He was just trying to destroy the law. So that kind of person, this Griffin was, and he was a scientist. He himself has invented one drug, and by which he become invisible. He has swallowed that drug and he become invisible. And then what happened next, that we are going to learn in this lesson. So we start the lesson. The two boys started in the surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. Now suppose somebody is walking on the road, and if we got the footprint of that particular person, we can understand, we will not puzzle with that, because it is a real normal thing that suppose somebody will walk, then we will get the footprint of a particular person. But nobody has walked from there, and even though we get the footprint, then we become so astonished or maybe puzzled. Sometimes we become scared also. Why? Because we have certain history that which we have heard from our forefathers, that there are certain ghosts are there, and who comes in our house, and they they make us ill and everything. So it was like that kind of thing was happening here, and two boys have witnessed that. The two boys have witnessed in surprise the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. What was a barefooted man doing on the step of a house in the middle of the London, and where was the man? And so they haven't seen that man, but they have seen the footprint of that man, and that is why they become so puzzled, and nobody is there, and how we can get the footprints of that person who is not here. As they gaze means look at very intently, gaze means what? Very intently looking at something. A remarkable sight met their eyes. A fresh footmark appeared from the nowhere. As earlier I told that suppose somebody is walking from there, and if we get the footprint of any person, then we can understand it's a normal thing. But nobody is walked from there, and we have got that, then it becomes so something puzzling thing. Same thing happened with these two boys, and they have, and after when they gazed very intently, they have got another fresh footprint. We saw somebody walked recently, then they become so astonished. Further footprints followed one after another, and they tried to follow each and with that footprints one after another, descending the steps and progressing down the street. The boys followed, fascinated. They were very attracted because something unusual they have found, right? Because I told earlier, something is not there, then too we have got the existence of that particular person, then it is fascinating, and that is why they become so attracted towards that footprints, until the muddy impressions became fainter and fainter. Okay, fainter and fainter means somebody has walked from the mud, and because mud was smashed to his feet, and that was till that mud is there underneath of his foot, till it will be printed on the tiles, and that is why they have seen that till that footprints become fainted. They followed that. The explanation of the mystery was really simple enough. What was the explanation? We'll see. Already I have mentioned in the beginning of the lesson. The bewildered, puzzled, confused boys had been followed a scientist who had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. Transparent means, glass is a transparent. We can see through the particular glass like that. Human body becomes transparent, but it was not only transparent, but it was very solid. So one can touch, one can feel the existence of that. Suppose we are there. Okay. The explanation of the mystery was really very simple. The B-Rider 2 boys had been following a scientist who had just discovered how to make a human body transparent. Griffin, the scientist, already I have mentioned in the name on the board that Griffin was the scientist who was the inventor of this invisible personality, invisible person. But he was lawless, as we have learned. The scientist had carried out the experiment after experiment to prove that human body could become invisible, and he made something like that. And what he did, he made the invention, he invented that human body can become invisible. Finally, he swallowed certain rare drugs, and his body became transparent as a sheet of glass. So his body, when he swallowed certain drugs, his body become like a sheet of glass. It was solid but transparent. Okay, so we can't judge. Just suppose any person is standing here, but who is transparent, we can see through, but we can touch, we can feel. Okay, we can't go through, we can touch. Okay, it was like that, though it was remain a solid like a glass. So we can understand at the beginning they have got the footprint of that, because it was solid body. It is not like that, it was not solid, it was solid. That is why when his feet were smashed with the mud, that mud was underneath of that particular Miss Griffin's feet. Brilliant scientist though he was, Griffin was rather a lawless person. He was very brilliant, no matter, because he did something extraordinary which cannot be done by any normal people. Okay, simple person cannot do that. But he was extraordinary. That is why he invented that. But he was not that good person. We have great respect for the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. We have respect for many scientists from India or in all over the world. But because they have done enormous activity, they have done enormous invention which was good for society. But Griffin, what was his quality? He was a lawless person. So if the person is lawless, he doesn't have any worry about the society, then we don't have any proud about him. We don't have any good faith about him. He was like that. He was a lawless person. This person was very brilliant, but he was lawless. He was not caring any other law. His landlord disliked him and tried to eject, means threw him out. Landlord, he was where he was living, threw him out. So in revenge, Griffin set fire to his house. So that type of person, when his landlord was not ready to keep him there, then what he did, he set fire to his house. So that type of person Griffin was. To get away without being seen, he had to remove his clothes. Thus it was that he became a homeless wanderer, without clothes, without money, and and quite invisible, until he happened to step in some mud and left footprint as he walked. So if he want to become invisible, he should not have clothes on his body. Then only he can become invisible, because what I said earlier, he was become transparent but solid. So suppose if we have any particular thing, and if we over some clothes on it, we can understand from the long distance also. Okay, so after his invention, his body become statue like glass. It was live body but statue like a glass. If anyone will wear any kind of clothes, then he would be visible with the clothes. So if he want to become invisible, he has to remove his clothes throughout. Then he only can be not be seen by people. That is why he has to roam nakedly, naked without clothes. And he was, because of his nature, he become homeless. He was wanderer. Nobody was ready to take him in the house, or nobody was ready to give his house to him for on rent basis. And he was away with the money, away with the everything. And as he was lawless person, nobody was his friend as well. So we'll see then and how we can understand him, because suppose he will smash with any mud or anything to his feet, then only we can understand that he is going through. He escaped easily through from the boys who followed his footprints in London, but his adventure were no means over. He had chosen a bad time of the year to wander about London without clothes. And now, suppose he want to become invisible, he want to remain invisible, he has to remove whole clothes from his body. And it was January, month of January. So you know better that if we can't, we have to put more blankets on our body in the month of June, because it's the winter season. And in London, that London is a very cold country. And suppose you are there in the month of January, you have to take extra precautions for the to save from the winter, chilly winter. And he was suppose he don't want to see by others, then he has to remove the clothes from his body. And that is why he was quite unfortunate. We can see the air was bitterly cold, and he could not do without his clothes. Instead of walking about the streets, he decided to slip into a big London store from Wop. And he was not a good person. Nobody was giving him shelter, and that is why he has to do certain things which was illegal. Okay, so he can't roam without clothes, naked way. Okay, nakedly he can't roam. So he wanted to go in one of the stores and can find out some certain warmth or warmness. Closing time arrived, and as soon as the doors were shut, Griffin was able to give himself the pleasure of clothing and feeding himself without regard to expense. And then when shop was about to close, he entered inside the shop, and he was very happy because without spending a single penny, he could get all the clothes to wear. Okay, he broke open boxes and wrappers and fitted himself out with the warm clothes. Soon, with the shoes and overcoat and a wide brimmed hat, he became a fully dressed and visible person, because something was there to show. Okay, on his body was become like a statue of, not statue, live statue of glass. So he wore everything, so he become now visible with the medium of the clothes. In the kitchen of the restaurant, he found cold meat and coffee, and he followed up the meal with the sweets and wine taken from the grocery store. Finally, settled down to sleep on the pile of the quilts. And then after having cold meat and some coffee, he found that heap of razai, quilt means what, razai. On that he got a chance to sleep. So he was very comfortable in the store. If only Griffin had managed to wake up in the good time, all might have been well. And he thought that he will wake up early in the morning till all the associates from the shop, the shopkeepers will come. So before that, he will manage to wake up and he will go from there, or he will remove the clothes from his body. But he could not do so. And before he woke up, some associates, some members, some workers of the shopkeeper had come in the shop. And as it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arrived in the next morning. When he saw a couple of them approaching, he panicked. He became so panicked because now he might get some beating, he might get captured with the people. And then he was become little panicked and began to run. They naturally gave chase. Of course, suppose somebody, a stranger, has come in the shop, then what they will do? They would surely chase. And they were chasing this Griffin. In the end, he was able to escape only by quickly taking off his newly found clothes, because that was the matter. He became invisible. How? When he will throw out all his clothes. That is why. And then he managed to quickly throw out all his clothes from his body, and then he became invisible and he escaped from their catch. So once more he found himself invisible but naked in the chilly January. So we can understand, suppose you will do something wrong, sure nature will take revenge from you. Right now we are facing this COVID-19 because we did something wrong with the nature. Actually it is a man-made, maybe it is told that it is a man-made virus. But now if you see that nature is very, very, enriched now. We can see greenery everywhere. Nothing happened with the nature, nothing happened to nature, but we are totally in cage. Right, all the animals are living very leisurely. They are enjoying the natural beauty. They are not affected with the coronavirus, but we are, because we did something wrong. We have just, you know, approached, or we totally, you know, captured all the nature's activity, and that is why. So we did something wrong, that is why we are paying the price right now. So similar way, he did something wrong, that is why he has to walk, he has to run in the very chilly air in London in the month of January, in a very, very great winter time. This time he decided to try to stock up a theoretical company in the hope of finding not only clothes but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulder. You know, his whole body become invisible. And that is why he was just trying to wear to cover his whole body, but he failed to cover his mouth, cover his face. So he wanted to go in one of the theater where he will get everything. Okay, so he wanted to find something like mustache or some whiskers or something to cover his face. And he went there in that Darley Lane, the center of the theater world. He soon found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later wearing a bandage round his forehead. So he came with the bandage rounding to his forehead, completely he has covered his forehead. Dark glasses, then false nose, this bogus nose, which was artificial, okay? Because nobody can understand him, nobody can recognize him, that is why. And big bushy side whiskers and a large hat to escape without being seen. He carelessly attacked the shopkeeper from behind. He was a lawless person, nothing was in his mind. If he will do something, inhuman activity, he doesn't care about that. And that is why he has, like that, he was person. And that is why, without thinking anything much, he attacked on the shopkeeper and he has robbed him and finding some money he could find, and he has taken the money from that shopkeeper. So we will stop here. But what we have learned here in this lesson, that we have learned the lesson that the name of the lesson was The Footprint Without Feet by Herbert George Wells. And we have taken the information about him, that he is a all-rounder writer. We can understand that he has enriched English literature. He was not only an English writer, but he has written many things in that. He has written dozens of novels. He has written short stories. He has done something social commentary as well. Then satirical work also. He has written biography, autobiography. He has written two books on the recreational war game also he has written, and he was known, or we can say right now also, he is known for the science, father of the science fiction. Okay, so all type of genre he has written. Then we have started with the lesson that this is the lesson about the science, the invention in the science. So what invention? That by the drinking of one of the drugs, one man can become invisible. And what was that name of the man? Griffin. Griffin was a scientist, but he was not good in nature. He was lawless person. He doesn't care about anything which was wrongly done. And then two boys followed him. When they saw the footprint without a person, they followed him. And then at last he has to throw out his all clothes from his body. He has to become naked, and then only he could not be seen by any other else. So there, that thing happened. Then again he it was mid January, where chilly winds were there, and it was in London, so he could not bear the chilly wind, and that is why he wanted to go in one of the garment shop. He went there after the shop is closed, and then he wore some clothes from there, and he had cold meat and other things also. He had coffee also, and he slept on rajai. In the morning, he wanted to wake up early in the morning before those workers will come, but unfortunately he couldn't woke up. And then two workers have seen him. They tried to attack on him, but he ran away, and again he has to throw away all his clothes from his body, and he could escape that only after that. Then he wanted to put cover on his whole mouth and face also. So he wanted to go for the theater where he will get everything. And then he managed to find one theater, and where he got the bandage to his forehead, and he could hide his face as well. And after that, he has robbed one of the shopkeeper, and he had got some money that we have seen in this lesson. This is the half part of the lesson. In next part, what exactly happened with this griffin, we will see. So today, what you have to do, you have to read the lesson twice, and then you write the flowchart of the lesson. Okay, so I hope that you have understood the lesson. Thank you. Thank you very much.